If you're following along in the free Java Online course, tricky Java number stuff is a good topic to hit when we've covered primitives and operators. One lesson I tell everyone when they're learning about computers is, computers do what you tell them to, not necessarily what you want them to. Too often, you'll say, "I know what will happen," and you'll be surprised by the outcome. Once you think about it a little more, you'll realize your mistake and say, "Oh yeah, well, here's a few more oh yeah moments for you." And if you're new to programming in Java and this video shocks you, don't worry. There's programmers out there who have many years of experience, and some of this video might still blow their minds. So, let's start. Every programmer, from the day that they start to learn programming, you're taught, don't divide by zero. It's bad. Computers die. Don't do it. Let's do it. What happens if we divide 1 by 0? So, what happens when we divide 1 by 0? What will this code do? Boom. Java dies. Java lang arithmetic exception, divide by 0. I guess that was expected. Want to do it again? Let's try it with floating point numbers. What does this print? If you're not sure what changed, I changed the integer literals to double literals. Huh, it prints infinity. No error. So, can you verify if an answer is infinity? If you tested the value against positive infinity, you'd get, well, what would you get? Well, let's run it. And the numbers are equal, because 1 divided by 0 does equal infinity. What about 0 divided by 0? What would that print? Well, that doesn't really make sense. And Java agrees, not a number. Now, what happens if we compare 0 divided by 0 and 0 divided by 0? Are these two equal? Nope, the numbers are not equal. You can't compare not a numbers. That always returns false when you use the equality operator. If you need to check for not a numbers, you need to use the float method is not a number. Let's play with floating point numbers more. Let's see if you know what minimum values are. What happens in this code? What gets printed? Your first thought might be, well, this is a trick question, so it has to be the min value. Or is the trick that it's the zero? Many programmers outsmart themselves when they see this question. Negative numbers are smaller than zero. So this code prints minus 2.14748364 to the ninth power. Not all that surprising, but some people are tripped up by it. So let's double down with doubles. What does this print? Again, if you're not sure what I changed, I'm now using the double class for the minimum value. Well, we already saw that. This is just with doubles. So we're going to double down and say that it's some bigger negative number, right? It prints zero. Min values for doubles are the smallest positive minimum value you can represent in a double. The smallest without actually being zero. The minimum value for an integer is negative, and the minimum value for a double and floats is positive. If you guess zero, gold star. We wanted to store 1, we can define our bytes. This is the bit pattern for 1. How do we define minus 1 using bits? Well, since it's a 2's complement number, let's try that. Minus 1 is bits, is all 1's. And it won't even compile. So how do you represent minus 1? Just add a minus sign. That's it. Literals are literals, not 2's complement numbers. So you need to use the sign operator with the binary literal to define negative numbers. All right, if I gave you a byte, call it B, are these three statements equivalent? That is, after we declare B to be equal to 0, do the following three statements do the same thing? Nope. In the first two cases, B will evaluate to 2 after execution. The first two will insert a cast back to byte when you compile. And the third, it won't even compile. The third won't compile since one is an integer literal. The one causes a widening conversion and the addition returns an integer, not a byte.
Well, what happens when you add two bytes? Neither are an integer, like the literal before.
This won't even compile. Addition returns integers. It doesn't matter if it's a byte or even if your answer fits into a byte.
Oh, well, what happens when you use the unary operator and add something that clearly will not fit into a byte? Let's go do it.
Okay, will this compile? Will it even run? Yes, it compiles and it runs. It prints out minus 122. You can even add something that's clearly not a byte, like 50,000. That prints 80. The result you're getting is the number that is modulo congruent to the number that you're trying to calculate.
If that surprises you, you might want to take a look at how computers store numbers, the lessons on DGU.com. Okay, last one for now. Let's play with the integer class in autoboxing. If we have an integer and set it to 1, then create another integer and set that to 1. Are the two integers equal using the equality operator? Remember, the integers are classes and the equality operator will test to see the two variable references reference the same integer instance. This is not looking at the value.
And they're equal. Did that surprise you? That means that A and B point to the same instance.
Okay, let's do the exact same thing, but in this case, let's use 128. The only change here is A and B now equal 128.
And they're not equal. These do not point to the same integer instance. If you use 1 and 1, they are equal. If you use 128 and 128, they're not equal.
Wow. The reason is Java doesn't like creating objects if it doesn't need to. For numbers less than 127, Java creates a cache of integer instances, anything within the range of a byte. So that's negative 128 to 127. You can verify this in the value of method of the integer class. So we've seen that we can divide by zero when using floating point numbers. We cannot compare nada numbers. Integers and doubles have minimum values that differ in sign. Literals are literals. It sucks doing math with bytes. And number classes are not always created when you create one. Know any other crazy number behavior in core Java? Let me know in the comments below. Till next time.